Hi, I'm Christian Pavlinski from Parkerhill Reality Labs, and welcome to an overview of our new plugin, BridgeXR. Now, the main idea behind BridgeXR was to create a plugin that manages your SDK-specific content so that you can implement once and target any variety of devices and user interfaces. So we did some research and development, and we came up with a plugin that provides all the tools you need to create content efficiently while keeping your core code independent of SDKs and platforms. In this demo, we'll be creating a throwable object. We'll be using SteamVR and Daydream. To do this, we'll use the component bridge, which is only one of the bridges that you'll find in our new plugin, BridgeXR. The component bridge allows you to dynamically load components based on defined SDK or toolkit. So for SteamVR, we'll want to add components that make the object able to be manipulated by positionally tracked controllers. On Daydream, we'll want to load in components that allow us to use the pointer that is included in their elements demo. Let's start by adding our component bridge to this object. Component bridge loader, and we can create a new component bridge. However, before this demonstration, I went ahead and created our throwable component bridge. You can see that I already have the SteamVR throwable selected. This is simply a cube that I found in their demo scene. It has the components that I need to make the object interactable. I went ahead and did the same thing for Daydream. If I go to this folder and I drag out the Daydream throwable, you can even see that it still has the position where it was sitting on the shelf in the object manipulation demo. I simply replaced the graphic with a cube. I'm going to add the Daydream throwable to our component bridge. If I go to the BridgeXR settings, you can see that I have SteamVR as the active bridge. Don't worry, you can create any number of identities by going to the Create menu and then BridgeXR and Bridge Identifier. This means you can support any platform or SDK or toolkit. When I hit play, you can see that the components are going to be added even before the game starts. This means that you won't have a slowdown in your application, and it also means that you can have objects that interact differently for each platform. You can see that we're using the scene bridge to load in the player rig, which means that we're loading a different additive scene dependent on bridge identifier. I went ahead and created a Daydream rig for our next demo. Let me select Daydream as our selected bridge identifier. Now we'll load in a Daydream rig, and our throwable object will have the Daydream throwable components. With the correct components added, we have like native support for manipulating objects onto platforms. This allows us to create a game that's core code is separated from the platform's interactions. And that concludes our demo. To recap, in our demo we saw how BridgeXR is integrated directly into the Unity editor. We also saw how BridgeXR loads in content dynamically, even before you hit play. Now let me explain why this solves the pain points of the traditional approach. Developing AR and VR applications is difficult because you have to support a wide range of devices. This means that traditionally, you would use wrappers instead of the native SDK, which means you could not support any device-specific features. With BridgeXR, you can load in the features for each device independently. Worse, wrappers are hard-coded to target devices, which means that toolkits often become stale and out of date, resulting in buggy and fragmented applications. With BridgeXR, everything is defined in the editor, like the bridge identifiers and input events. Thank you for watching, and look for BridgeXR on the Unity Asset Store.